Hello guys, welcome back to a new Darkness Rises video. In this video guys, I'm gonna have a guide for the new event Regina and show you how you can get more rewards from this event, okay? So what type of rewards you can get? Well, I'm gonna show you. So I already got a decent amount, even if I didn't play that much yesterday. So the rewards you get, you'll get them from the corrupted version of the Regina, okay? And they will be stored in your account inventory, and these are the Regina treasure chests, okay? I'm gonna open then at the end of the video, but from these ones, what can you obtain? So let's see. By the way, you can also buy them from the event shop with Regina tokens. With this, or they are called queen coin, okay? The queen coins, you can get them from defeating Regina. If you go for normal version, you get 100. If you go for hard, you get 200. You get double. Plus, you get some extra gold, which helps. And corrupted garden, in here, you'll get the corrupted Regina at a chance. So in here. By the way, the corrupted Regina you can play only if you are in a guild, okay? So make sure you join a guild, and the first day when you join, you cannot play the corrupted Regina, only from second day. And you can play with two other guildmates, the corrupted version, which is a stronger version, but I'm gonna do a gameplay for that. But first I want to show you what you can get, okay? So this chest, like I told you, you can also buy for 1000 Regina tokens, okay? And there's unlimited amount, so there is not a specific. So that means if you, for example, defeat the Regina 5 times, you get, okay, because you get 200 from the second difficulty, that's 1000 tokens, so you'll be able to get every day around one treasure, Regina treasure chest. What can you get from here? Well, the most important things, guys, is the rank L skill change tickets, okay? And also, on top of that, there are other rewards, like you're gonna see exactly what you can get, because I'm gonna open, okay? So, but I think they are worth it, okay? So how you can get more of those chests? I'm gonna explain, guys. First thing, let's see. So I explained to you, when you defeat the normal Regina, okay, in here, this you go solo, okay, there is a chance to get the corrupted version. For the corrupted version, you can you need to be in a guild, okay, and you can access from here. Right now I didn't get one, but I'm gonna try to get. So actually, let's do that. So I'm gonna go for the hard, and you're gonna see my strategy. I'm gonna explain after. You're gonna see what I'm doing. So by the way, for the normal Regina, you have maximum like 2 tickets, but they regen every 6 hours. So that means, you know, one day you get around 4 tickets, 4 entries, which is good. So 4, that means if you defeat her, 800 queen coins, okay? If you go for normal, you get 100 multiplied by 4, 400, okay? But let's try the hard. So let's go. And you're gonna see my strategy, you're gonna see why. So if you are new for Regina, you have to know, the more damage and the more health you take from her, the stronger she will become. You can see the level right there on the top right side, close to the exit button. Progress 2 out of 10. So maximum difficulty for her is 10, okay? So my idea, why I'm not trying to kill her? I'm trying just to, I'm going semi-auto, because I'm too strong for her. I want to reach just a specific level, okay? So I don't want to go higher. Okay, so now, oh, I have the, I shouldn't have used the vital power weapon because that regens my health. So the idea is to equip some gear that's not as strong, because you want to die faster before she reaches like maximum, let's say, level 6 or 7. Now it's 7, so I'm gonna let her, okay. Why? See, because I want to get 6 or 7, level 6 or 7 for Corrupted Regina. And I still get 200 tokens, as you can see, event tokens. I get just less gold, but I still get the 200. Why you want the level 7 or 6, Regina? Well, guys, let's go to guild, because if you played it, you'll see the higher levels, like level 8, 9 and 10, you cannot solo it. Only if you go and if you are strong and your guildmates are strong, then you can go with them and maybe have a chance to defeat her. But level 6 and 7 or under, you can still solo. Let's go. So as you can see, after you get the corrupted version, it will go here, and it's for, you have 1 hour and 30 minutes to defeat her. If you don't defeat her from the first attempt, so maximum battle count, battle count, see, 5, that's the amount of times you can enter a corrupted Regina per day. So you need to spend those wisely. If you enter multiple times for same difficulty, that means you consume all the entries. You want to have one entry per Regina, so you'll get 5 times the reward. So if you defeat level 6 and 7, if I'm not mistaken, for level 7, see what rewards, you get 2 Regina treasure chest. So you want to maximize the amount of chest you get per day. So 2 multiply by 5, in theory, that will be 10 from one character, 10 Regina treasure chest, plus another one you get from the shop, okay, with the tokens. So that's 11. 11 per character, that will be, how many characters? 77 of this per day, that's a lot. But let's see if I can make it. So level, I'm not sure if level 6 also gives 2 Regina treasures. I'm gonna go to the, so let's go. If you can go with your guildmates, it's even better, because higher level Regina will give you up to 3 of those chests. But me, I don't have that option, so I'm gonna try to do it by myself. If you don't defeat her from the first attempt, oops. Oh, I know what happened. If you don't defeat her from the first attempt, you'll consume one entry, but you can continue and continue to challenge her, and the she won't start from full health, she will start from the HP remain, okay? So if you manage to get her down to half health and you go back again, she will start from half health, okay? So don't worry about that. But the idea, you want to defeat her in one run, okay? Why? Because you want to save the other ones so you can get more Regina and more rewards from her. And as you can see, the vital power still is very useful, because it will keep you alive. The damage you do, it's enough. You have 3 minutes time, so it's plenty time. And my health is still full, as you can see. So this is a good strategy. So the same method I used in the Chaos Abyss, like having HP regen, having regen from vital power and so on works for this. So see, I got two. Plus you get, don't forget, the other rewards, the crafting materials for costumes. You get three. And you get points. And at the end of the season, you get, I'm gonna show you. So the idea is to, like I told you, to maximize the amount of rewards. And this is a good method, in my opinion. Let's go really fast and read the patch notes, because I'm gonna, because I want to explain more why I'm doing this. So okay, one second, guys. And then I'm also gonna open the chest, the one that I have, to see what I'll get. So let's scroll down to Regina. Don't forget about Mimic. I might do a video about that also. So what I want to show you guys is the, so when you defeat the normal or hard Regina, as it, so there are two versions, normal and hard. For normal, if your power is lower, go for normal. Or if your alts are lower, go for normal. You'll be able to get her to defeat her. So that means you get level 10 rewards, which will be one chest. Okay, one chest you get. But, and also the chance for the level 5 Regina. So here you can see the level of the Regina you get from defeating different Regina version with different progress level. So for normal, okay, normal Regina progression 1, if you reach only progression 1, you have 45% chance to get corrupt Regina level 1. If you reach level 5, you have 57% chance to get corrupt Regina level 3, and so on. For level 10, if you defeat normal level 10, that means to kill her, okay, you have 70% chance to get corrupt Regina level 5. Okay, so that means the corrupt Regina level 5, I'm gonna show you after what rewards gives. So why I told you to enter hard, if you have decent amount of power, okay, because as you can see, if you get to, let's say, if you get her to level hard, wait, okay, to progress, okay, progress 3, no, even to progress from progress 1, actually, so even if you're not able to do much damage, you still get corrupt Regina level 6, 70% chance. And the higher you go, if you reach up to level from level 7 progress, you get corrupt Regina level 8. You don't want level 8 if you are not that strong, or if your guildmates are not that strong. So you want maximum level 7. So that's why I try not to go further to take from her HP higher than progress 6, or yeah, 6, because at 7 you get corrupted Regina level 8. So if you go hard mode and you do some damage, doesn't even matter, you'll get a corrupted Regina level 6 or 7, okay, which is good. Why you want level 6 or 7, I think, let's see. So here you can see the corrupted Regina clear rewards, so depending on the level. So if you defeat a level 5 Regina or lower, you get just one Regina treasure chest. If it's level 6 and 7 and 8, you get 2. So you don't want 8. You still get 2, but you won't be able to defeat her in one go. So you need to consume more entries. Okay? And for 9 and 10 you get 3, Well, that's only for strong, really strong players. So that's why I told you, try to get Regina level 6 or 7, okay? Especially 6 actually is more certain, more, because level 6 is easier to defeat, okay? So here you can see what can you get, okay? So you can get gold from the Regina treasure chest. You can get gold boost tickets. Gold boost tickets are quite useful, okay? Soul fossils 100, also very useful. And rank as refined stone choice. And the most important is the rank L skill change ticket, okay? Plus the chance to get shiny Regina wing chest. With shiny Regina wing chest, we have also the collection to complete the new collection here, season limited, and we get extra 19,500 attack, okay? And this is permanent. If you don't have an S++ wing, get this from the event, from those chests. So that's why I suggested to do the hard difficulty, even with your alts, okay? Because you have a chance to get level 6 or 7 Regina. Don't get her. Don't take too much from her health. You want to get 6, 7 Regina, so you can solo her and defeat her in one go. Okay, now let's go, guys, and open, see what we'll get from these ones. Now let's go 7, then 10, 10. Why I cannot see? I cannot. Wow. Okay, let's go 10. See, I cannot go lower then. That's weird. Okay, so I got 3 gold boost tickets. Yeah, let's see if I can get. You know what? Let's open all. Any rank L skill? Come on. Come on, give me one. Okay, so I got one. So that means you need lots of them. And I got one. Soul fossils. So the most what I see, you get gold boosts, which are good if you need gold. And some gold. And lots of berries, okay? Some S refined choice chest. So anyways, this event will last for a while. Let's see how much. Till next update, actually, about 3-4 weeks, something like that. So plenty time to farm. If we get around 70 Regina chest per day, in 10 days that's 700. So I believe from 700 you'll get quite a decent amount of those weapon and accessory traits, okay? Because you need them, see, to change the weapon skill, and also for accessories if you want to get better. Same, see, you need 4 only for the for the accessories, so that's why you want them. So yeah, guys, this was the video. Let me know what you think and how many of those chests you got so far, and see you in the next video. Bye.